Howdy y'all, it's Jordan Smith, chief builder and owner at Smith House Company. My buddy Kyle Stumpenhorst with RR Buildings and I are going to show you the correct way to install LP TechShield Radiant Barrier. Make sure you go check out the written instructions at lpcorp.com.
This simple installation process means that up to 97% of the radiant heat in roof panels will be blocked from emitting into a home's attic. This could be huge when it comes to energy savings. Let's get started. LP TechShield Radiant Barrier installs just like regular roof sheathing, but it has a thin, durable layer of aluminum engineered to block radiant heat from entering a home's attic. Place the skid-resistant side up with the APA trademark stamp side, the foil side, facing down against the structural supports. Install with the long strength axis dimension of the panel across supports, with the panel continuous over two or more spans. Panel end joints should occur over framing. Stagger the end joints in each succeeding row. Provide 1/8 of an inch space at panel ends and edges. For low slope roofs and in applications where structural support spacing is maximized, we recommend installing panel edge clips mid-span on all unsupported edges. This makes the panels even stiffer. Fasten panels 3/8 of an inch from panel edges using 8D common nails. If any edge swelling occurs, all raised joints should be sanded flat. Cover the roof deck as soon as possible with roofing felt or shingle underlayment, and remove wrinkles before installing shingles. That's it! Now you're ready for the next step in your installation process, and you've installed the original and number one brand of radiant barrier sheathing.
And that is how you install LP TechShield. Go check out Kyle at RR Buildings.
And Jordan at Jordan Smith Builds. Thanks a lot, everybody.